Right. And Garrett, stand by for a moment, if you will. We have some major breaking news in the Mueller investigation. Let's get right to it. Sarah Murray now joining us by phone. Sarah, tell us exactly what just happened.
We are learning that Roger Stone, who is President Trump's longtime political advisor, was arrested at his home in Fort Lauderdale this morning. He has been indicted. This has now been confirmed both by Roger Stone's attorney as well as the special counsel's office. I believe we also have some exclusive video from this morning. So he was indicted. It says it's on 7 counts, one of obstruction of justice of an official proceeding, 5 counts of false statements, and 1 count of witness tampering. Roger Stone, of course, as we know, has been under scrutiny from the special counsel for years, basically. We've seen about a dozen of his associates interviewed him before the grand jury, and Stone's team had no idea that this was coming today. I talked to his lawyer last night. They said they still had heard no word from the special counsel whatsoever. So it was a huge surprise this morning that they showed up and they took Roger Stone into custody this morning.
Sarah, do you know who arrested him? What agency?
We believe it is the FBI that arrested him at his home this morning. To be honest, I have to tell you, I called his lawyer to let him know as soon as we were getting word that Stone was taken into custody, and we found out about this before his lawyer did.
All right. 1 count of obstruction, 5 counts of false statements, 1 count of witness tampering. And I should note that they just posted, the Department of Justice just posted this official information just now, and we'll read through it as soon as we can. But Sarah, to the extent that you understand the specifics in these charges, obstruction, false statements, witness tampering, give us some details there.
Well, we're still, as you pointed out, we just got this information that Stone has been taken into custody, just got this information about the documents, so we're looking over it. I believe that it is probably going to have to do with some of his testimony to Congress. Again, I have not had a chance to read through these fully, but we know that Mueller's team recently requested from the House Intelligence Committee a copy of Roger Stone's testimony. And we know that they had asked some other witnesses about the possibility that Roger Stone may have made some false statements in Congress. So we're going to dig into this.
Right.
But, you know, it's 7 counts. This is no small deal.
You know, Sarah, I just opened the document right now, and I think our viewers are going to have to bear with us as we read this in real time. But among the very first things I see here is during the summer of 2016, Stone spoke to senior Trump campaign officials about Organization One, which has always been WikiLeaks, is my understanding, and information it might have had that would be damaging to the Clinton campaign. Stone was contacted by senior Trump campaign officials to inquire about future releases by Organization One. Explain the significance of that right there, because that paragraph I just read says that Roger Stone and the Trump campaign, it seems to me, had conversations in the summer about WikiLeaks.
This is one of the huge questions, is whether Roger Stone had an early indication that WikiLeaks was going to release damaging information on Hillary Clinton, information that would be beneficial to Donald Trump, and whether he shared that early heads up with people inside the Trump campaign. Now, Stone has vehemently denied over and over again that he had any sort of early look at basically anything other than, you know, what the American public was seeing as WikiLeaks was releasing it, but this indictment does suggest that the special counsel's office believes he got some kind of information and was in touch with some folks at the Trump campaign about these releases.
And what does it tell you that he has been indicted on these 7 counts by a grand jury yesterday, arrested this morning? If people are just waking up, Roger Stone has just been taken into custody, about false statements, obstruction of justice, and witness tampering. That's not the none of those are about the crimes of collusion. This is about the crimes of cover-up.
But remember here, what Joan just read is really important, which is that there were contacts between he and the Trump campaign and Organization One, WikiLeaks. And so this is a really important point, which is that he may have lied about that. The government may be able to prove that he lied about it. That doesn't mean that there was involvement. It means that he didn't tell the truth about what happened. And so what's really important, though, is that if he's lying about those connections, it means ostensibly that the government can prove that those connections existed.
Among other things, Garrett Graff, if you're with us, Stone, the government says, made multiple false statements to the House Senate Intelligence Committee about his interactions regarding Organization One, again, regarding WikiLeaks, and falsely denied possessing records that contain evidence of these interactions. So the special counsel telling us they have evidence that Roger Stone had discussions about WikiLeaks.
Yeah, and John, I'm reading this document at the same time you are here, and one of the things that stands out to me is, in many ways, what we're seeing is the other side of that Jerome Corsi in aborted plea agreement from December, which, if you remember, Jerome Corsi, Roger Stone associate, a conspiracy theorist, he had come, seemingly within hours of signing a plea agreement with Bob Mueller. Then it all blew up, and he leaked the plea agreement he was about to sign. That contained many of the communications that we're now seeing between him and Roger Stone that are in this new indictment this morning. So in some ways, Roger Stone is now getting indicted for the communications he was having with Jerome Corsi.
Sarah, look, as you know, there was so much talk about why hasn't Roger Stone been interviewed? What does this mean? Why hasn't he been contacted? So many people had been reached out to by Robert Mueller's team, and we knew about it from our reporting, and Roger Stone was always the question mark. And this morning, many of those questions have been answered. The fact that he was arrested, as you believe, by FBI agents, taken into custody, and indicted on these seven counts.
Yeah, that's right. And, I think that Roger was clear-eyed enough, and his lawyers were clear-eyed enough to know that the reason he had not been interviewed was because he was a target of this investigation. But they were also very much in the dark about what he might ultimately be charged with. They felt like he had not colluded, that he had not obstructed justice. Obviously, the special counsel has a number of charges relating to obstruction of justice there. And I do think the question going forward is, okay, what does the special counsel's office want him for? Do they want him on these obstruction of justice charges because they do think he could provide more information about his contact with WikiLeaks and his contact with the campaign, and ultimately they want to put pressure on him and they want him to cooperate? Or are they actually looking to, to bring these charges against him and to move forward? And do they not need his help and his participation? And that's still a very open question in this.
All right, Sarah, we have to let you go for just a moment to go do more reporting and read through this. Garrett and Ann, stick around. Just one more thing I want to read, and we're going to take a quick break because, again, we're going to digest this all. But I want to read this and get your reaction. After the July 22nd, 2016 release of stolen DNC emails by Organization One, that's WikiLeaks, a senior Trump campaign official was directed to contact Stone about any additional releases and what other damaging information Organization One had regarding the Clinton campaign. Stone thereafter told the Trump campaign about potential future releases of damaging material by Organization One. And again, July 22nd here, which is fairly early on in the summer, this is conversation and some level of coordination between at least one Trump campaign official and Stone about the WikiLeaks hack.
This is enormously important. If you think about conspiracy, and one of the questions Robert Mueller is investigating is, did the Trump campaign conspire with the Russian government? We know the Russians hacked into the emails. We know that they were trying to influence the election. To conspire with somebody, you have to share their criminal intent, have to share the intent or the goal, which here would be to release emails that were detrimental to Hillary Clinton, and to have taken an overt act, like, for example, potentially making that call to Roger Stone and saying, hey, do you know when it's going to happen? What's the timing? And, I would argue that this is probably the closest evidence we've seen. It's almost a three-legged stool. You've got the Trump campaign. You've got the Russian government with this information. What we've been missing is the piece in the middle. And we had a little bit of it from Corsi, but this to me comes.
But what I just haven't gotten yet from the indictment, because we're only on page four as we come through it, is whether or not Stone was a charlatan, whether or not he actually was having contacts. I haven't gotten to the part where it says that he was in touch. WikiLeaks denies it, as it says in here, but Stone always said that he did. And so we don't know yet if it actually does all weave together.
The only thing we know is that Robert Mueller and his team does know, but we do not know yet. And so we're still waiting for that.
And again, we're talking about Stone's communications about Organization One.
WikiLeaks.
Well, that's WikiLeaks. So what did Stone say to Organization One? Did they talk?
What did they say to him?
And Garrett, quick last thought, and we're going to take a quick break. But before we go read more, your final thought on all this we just discussed?
Yeah. So what's hard to know at this exact moment, and Ann sort of hinted at this, is whether this is all that Mueller has on Roger Stone, or is this the beginning? Because it is notably an indictment that's focused only on really that those false statements and that obstruction, and it doesn't get into some of those charges that we would expect to see, like conspiracy against the United States or campaign finance violations that could point to sort of those larger questions of collusion. So the question is that still to come?
All right, guys, dig in. Get a copy of this indictment we're looking at right now. Dig in. We're going to have much more on this. Stick around. Breaking news. Roger Stone taken into custody by the FBI. What does this mean for the Mueller investigation? More coming up.
Hi, everyone. My name's Mike. I'm the creator of Mox News. And for the last 15 years, I have been telling you that as long as I have the support of the community that I serve, Mox News will post videos forever. And that's the truth. As long as I have your support, no one could ever make me stop. Unfortunately, currently, less than one half of 0.1% of Mox News viewers ever donate, tip, or contribute anything back. Again, let me make that really clear. Much less than one half of 0.1% ever give anything back. And to those of you who have donated to Mox News, I want to thank you so much, because it's because of your generosity that we have been able to bring attention to important videos that millions and millions of eyes would have never seen. And I think that that's an amazing thing that we've been able to make happen together. And I can't thank you enough for helping me make that happen. So it's not too late. If you'd like to see Mox News covering the 2020 presidential election, if you can't imagine the 2020 presidential election without Mox News, please, there's still time. You can make a difference. It's easy to make a contribution, donation, or tip. You can go to moxnews.com, or in the text body of this video, there are clickable links to the Patreon page or to the PayPal page. And again, it should take less than 2 minutes to make a donation, and your donation can make a big difference. So I thank you all. Stay cool. One of these days, this war is going to end, and it would be awesome if Mox News could be there to celebrate that day with you.